Merry Christmas, everybody! All right. There are lights. Let's all stand together. Lord Jesus, thank you so much for the opportunity to be here together in your house as we celebrate the incarnation of Christ. Lord, thank you for everyone here. Thank you for this community. Lord, I thank you for all those who are participating tonight in the service. Lord, I just pray that our hearts would be one with yours tonight, that you would be glorified. In your name we pray. Amen. Join the world.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing.
The stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth.
Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth.
Oh, Christ, whose glory fills the skies, Christ, the everlasting light, Son of righteousness, arise and triumph for these chains of mine. Come, thou long-awaited one, I will never be the same. So here I wait in hope of you, all my soul's longing through and through. Day spring from on high be near, and day star in my heart appear. Dark and cheerless is the morn until your love in me is born, and joyless is the evening sun until Emmanuel has come. So here I've waited hope of you, all my soul spring from on high being near, and day star in my heart appear. So here I've waited hope of you, all my soul's longing through and through. Day spring from on high being near, and day star in my heart. Don't get so busy that you miss giving just a little kiss to the ones you love. Don't even wait a little while to give them just a little smile. A little is enough.
How many people are crying? People. Don't save it all for Christmas Day. Find a way to give a little love every day. Don't save it all for Christmas Day. Find a way, 'cause holidays have come and gone. Jesus lives on, so give on love.
How could you wait another minute? I love this woman when you're in it. Oh, baby, that's a fact. Saying I love you's always better. Seasons, reasons, they don't matter. So don't hold back.
Save it all for Christmas Day.
Stop to see the great fir tree that stood within the square. I watched it sparkling light shine through the cold and snowy air. Then some movement caught my eye below its branches green. Then I saw a little boy with tangled golden curls and blue eyes dancing full of life. The life had been so cool. He said, "Nice night, Santa, come. I hope he comes to me and sees me just as you did beneath the Christmas tree. Silent night, oh, holy night, how clearly, Lord, I see but for thy grace. It could be me. There somewhere bells will ring as I slipped off my coat, wrapped it around his shoulder and held his body close. On the night that Christ was born, there's no way I could leave this cold and hungry orphan boy beneath the Christmas tree. Silent night, oh holy night, I took him home with me. But for the grace he could be me, there'd be me the Christmas tree.
Incarnate love divine, star and angels gave the sign. Bow to babe on bended knee, the savior of humanity. Unto us a child is born, he shall reign forevermore. No.
Come and see what God has done. God.
Well, in just a few minutes, I want us to think about Christmas. Thank you for all the singers and the songs. Your talent is great. The message is greater, and that's why we're here tonight. But Christmas is a lot of things. Christmas is a lot of things. It's a celebration. It's a celebration of a milestone for no other reason, a milestone in history. We measure history by the birth of Jesus, everything before his birth, before Christ, everything after in the year of our Lord. It can be a sad time, too. It's a reflective time. We think about our relationship with God. We think about our relationship with others, family members, loved ones, and we've all lost people like that, and we're saddened by that. And sometimes at a holiday season, especially maybe at a holiday season, that can be a difficult thing. Christmas is also a call to worship. And one of the great songs we sing every year at Christmas is, Oh Come Let Us Adore Him. That's what the message of Christmas is. It's an invitation to adore the Lord Jesus Christ. And that's what we've done tonight. And I hope that's what you've done throughout this Christmas season, but not only through the Christmas season, but all year long. I hope and pray that you're responding to that call to worship Christ, who is God in the flesh, God incarnate. And that's what we've done tonight. There's one more thing I want to share about Christmas, and there are many other things, but there was one more thing I'll share, and I want us to focus on this for just a few minutes, and it's this. Christmas is a test. It's a test. There's a special test, and I'm not scientific at all, so I'll probably fumble this one, but I'm going to try it anyway. There's a special test that's used to determine whether something is acidic or whether it's alkaline. It's called the litmus test. Sometimes it's called the acid test. And litmus is a dye that is extracted from slow-growing plants. And it has the properties that enable people who are in the know to use it. And if it is transmitted to something that's acidic, that thing will turn red. If it's not, if it's more alkaline, it'll turn blue. And there are really two definitions of the litmus test. The scientific definition is, a test for acidity or alkalinity. But that's not what we're going to use. We're going to talk about the other meaning of the acid test or the litmus test. And it's this, a decisively indicative test. And so when you hear this term litmus test, it's a reference to something that's setting us apart. That when we apply the litmus test to our thinking and to our values and to who we worship and to who we are and who we believe God is, it's a very significant test. And so what I'm going to say tonight is not only is Christmas a test, but I'm going to say Christmas is a litmus test. In fact, I'm going to say Christmas is the litmus test of all litmus tests. And in the second chapter of Luke, the passage that has the bulk of the Christmas story with which we're so familiar, part of that story gets lost because we hear about the birth of Jesus in Bethlehem and, you know, the manger and then the angel and the shepherds and all that. But then we get to verse 21 and we just kind of let it slide. But what happens after the main part of the Christmas story that we all focus on is that Mary and Joseph did what every Jewish couple would do who had the ability to do this. They waited the appropriate time, 8 days. They were in the vicinity of Jerusalem. They took Jesus to the temple in Jerusalem to be dedicated. And that was so significant. And while they were there, amazing things happened. There was this older woman named Anna, the prophetess, and she prophesied over Jesus. And then there was an old, strange man there named Simeon. And Simeon had been given a promise by God that he would not die until he saw the Messiah. And so when he sees Mary and Joseph with Jesus, prompted by the Holy Spirit, he goes, and imagine this, moms, here's this strange old man, and he takes the baby out of her arms, and he puts him in his arms, and he blesses God for fulfilling his promise. And then he says in verse 34, he says, Behold, this child is appointed for the fall and rise of many in Israel, and for a sign to be opposed. And he says to Mary, A sword will pierce even your own soul to this end, that the thoughts from many may be revealed. The thoughts from many may be revealed. Or as one translation put it, it will show what people are really thinking. And so with that being the case, here's my little thesis tonight, and then we're going to wrap up the service. It's simply this. Christmas is a test because Christmas reveals what's really in our hearts, especially, primarily, as it relates to whether or not we believe we need a Savior. That's why it says that the hearts were tested. The hearts would be tested by the coming of Christ, because it emphasizes the fact that the world was in need of a Savior, and God in His love sent us a Savior. But here's what I found. This is my experience. Most people don't believe that, or at least they don't live like they believe that. And so here's the issue tonight before we close the service. The real issue is this. How do you do on this test? Do you believe that you needed a Savior? Do you really believe that there was enough sin in your life that you could do nothing about, that it required what God did in sending Jesus on that first Christmas to be our Savior? I'll close with a verse from the Apostle Paul in Galatians chapter 2. In that epistle, he talks about our freedom in Christ, and he talks about being crucified with Christ. And then he says this in chapter 2, verse 21. He said, I do not nullify the grace of God. I do not nullify the grace of God. For if righteousness comes through the law, then Christ died needlessly. What Paul is saying is this. If there's any way for anyone, anywhere, to be able to be made righteous before God, apart from what God did through Jesus, then Jesus didn't need to die. He didn't need to come. But God's verdict was this, that because all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God, He gave us, through Jesus, the greatest gift of all, the gift, the opportunity to be forgiven and to be in a relationship with Him, the last for all eternity. So yes, Christmas is a celebration. Christmas is a call to worship, a time for reflection, a historic milestone, many other things. But tonight I want you to understand this as you go. Christmas is a test. It's the acid test. It's the litmus test for you and for me. Let's pray together. Father, I thank You tonight that You loved us so much that You sent Jesus to be our Savior, not just to be a baby in the manger, but to be our Savior, to die on Calvary's cross for the remission of our sins. And I pray tonight for myself, and I pray for every person here, that You would help us to pass the test of recognizing what Paul said in Galatians 2, if righteousness comes through the law, if it comes any other way, then Christ died for nothing. But we know He didn't die for nothing. He didn't come for nothing. He came to set us free. Help us to find that freedom in Him. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Sing together, Silent Night.
Silent night, holy night,
God bless you. Merry Christmas.